Hello children, welcome to my channel Quick Learn with Vijisha. Today I'll be doing class 6 history chapters reading. We'll be reading 2 pages daily so that you can understand how the sentences are to be read and how to read out the pronunciations also. So let's see how to do this. We will start with the first chapter, the Indian subcontinent and history, geographical conditions and the course of history, geographical features of India, the Indian subcontinent. 1.1. Geographical conditions and history. In the 5th standard, we saw at some length that there is a close relationship between man and his environment. We saw how the changes in the lifestyle of the early man and his technology were related to the changes in his surroundings. We also reviewed the history of human civilization from the Stone Age to the agricultural civilizations that flourished on the banks of rivers. History is a coherent account of the significant past events in the progress of human culture. Time, place, society, and individuals are the 4 major pillars of history. We cannot write history without them. Of these 4 components, place is related to geography or geographical conditions. In this sense, history and geography are inseparable. History is influenced by geographical conditions in many ways. Our diet, clothing, housing, occupation, in fact, all human life in any region depends to a large extent on its geographical characteristics. For example, the life of the people in hilly regions is more strenuous than that of the people on the plains. Not much fertile land is available in the hilly regions, while in the plains it is available on a large scale. That is why grains and vegetables are scarce in hilly areas. In comparison, people on the plains get them in a sufficient measure. Naturally, this has an impact on the diet of the people. In hilly regions, people depend more on hunting and gathering for their food. We also find other such differences in the lifestyle of the people of the hilly regions and those of the plains. The climate, rainfall, agricultural produce, flora and fauna of the region where we live are the sources of our livelihood. The lifestyle and culture of a region develops with their support. Human settlements have flourished wherever the means of living are plentiful. Over a period of time, these settlements develop further into villages and towns. But sometimes, reasons like the degradation of the environment, drought, invasions, etc., lead to the scarcity of those means. People are forced to leave their settlements. Villages and towns become. We see many such instances in history. Thus, we see that there is a very close relation between history and geography. Geographical features of India. Our country, India, extends far and wide. At its north lie the Himalayas, to the east the Bay of Bengal, to the west the Arabian Sea, and to the south the Indian Ocean. Except for the islands of Andaman, Nicobar and Lakshadweep, the rest of the country is contiguous. We have to take into account this region, henceforth referred to as ancient India. When we study the ancient history of India, before 1947, today's Pakistan and Bangladesh were also a part of India. The following regions are seen to be important when we look at the course of Indian history. Himalayas, the plains of Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra rivers, the Thar Desert, the Deccan Plateau, the coastal regions, the islands in the seas. And Himalayas. The Hindu Kush and Himalaya ranges have created an impenetrable wall on the northern side of the Indian subcontinent. This wall has separated the Indian subcontinent from the deserts of Central Asia. However, there is a land route through the Khyber and Bolan passes in the Hindu Kush mountains. This route was connected to an ancient trade route. The trade route from China passed through Central Asia and reached Arabia. It is known as a Silk Route or Silk Road. Because silk was the main commodity exported to the Western countries using this route. The route through the passes was used by many foreign invaders to enter ancient India. Many foreign travelers also came to India by this route. The plains of the Sindhu Ganga Brahmaputra. This region consists of the basins of the three big rivers, Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. This region extends from Sindhu, Punjab in. So children, this way we will be doing 2 pages everyday reading so that you can understand how to read the sentences, where to use the full stops, the commas and the punctuations. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching my video. Thank you, students.